I'm not what you would call a historian. Kind of an idiot when it comes to, really, anything in general. But specifically World War I. So when 1917 was announced, I was more interested in how it was filmed and less about if it's historically accurate. In fact, really all I know about World War I is that it was a complete disaster, it was messy, tons of people died, and it didn't really end until Wonder Woman stormed No Man's Land and took down Ares. Outside of that, it's all up in the air. So I'm gonna give you my thoughts on the film. Sam Mendes directs a stunning film here, one that's pretty much nonstop from beginning to end. It lasts just shy of 2 hours, and this thing is just constantly moving because the camera is constantly moving behind our characters as they go from set piece to set piece. They shoot this thing like it's a one take. Clearly there's some cuts made. I could make some educational guesses when those cuts occurred. I think I counted two or three times that it seemed kind of obvious, but my God, this movie is a cinematic masterpiece. It's a tour de force in filmmaking. I often was sitting back, not so much taken in by everything going on in the picture as far as the story's concerned or the acting, which are both great, but more so, how did they get the camera into the ditch and then out of it? Or how did they get the camera to go down the side of a building and through some explosions so seamlessly? This thing is filmed with such a craft behind it. Everybody involved should be commended, and I just can't praise it enough from a technical standpoint. As far as the story's concerned and the acting, it's all top tier too. There's just very little of it. Our movie follows two young corporals who have to traverse the countryside to deliver an important message before it's too late. The whole thing, it takes place on a Friday and a Saturday. It's a pretty shitty weekend. Before the movie started, I was in line behind some Yahoo who was trying to use one of those digital pop machines, touching all the buttons, mixing all the drinks, and I'm just sitting there with my dick in my hand waiting for him to get done so I can go see the movie, thinking to myself, you know what? Life kind of sucks hard right now. And then I saw the film and it kind of put things into perspective. Life does suck hard right now. Dean Charles Chapman and Dean McKay are the stars here. They're the leads. They have a great rapport together. I never found myself like bored of their dialogue or I didn't find any of it tedious. Nothing overstays its welcome. If they chat it up and have a fun story, it goes quick. And then we're off to another, you know, fantastic set piece. The feel of the movie is very intense. It reminded me of The Revenant. Or is it Reverent? I think it's Revenant. It reminded me of The Revenant with Leonardo DiCaprio. Another film that has some long take shots and it just kind of is a really visceral experience. I had that here. I don't know if I'd really enjoy watching this at home. And I never watched The Revenant again because it was very much just kind of, there's certain movies to me that are almost like a ride, you know, like Gravity. I saw that in 3D on like, you know, one of the jumbo screens and I had no desire to ever watch it again. It was like one of those Mystery Mine rides where you're in the moving chair and you're going down like a roller coaster through like a mine shaft or under the ocean floor and sharks are coming at you. It had that kind of feeling to me where unless I could relive that experience again with the same scenario, there's no reason for me to go back. I think that is kind of how it is with Avatar too. You know, with the 3D on and you're really immersed in the world, you get just a different level of experience than you can get sitting in the comfort of your own chair. So if you're on the fence as to whether or not to see this, I would absolutely go to theaters and watch it if you have any sort of inclination to see it at all. Don't wait for this one to come out at home. I just don't think you're gonna get the same level of excitement out of it. Much like Gravity, I have no reason to watch that again. It's probably a perfectly okay film at home. It's gonna lose a lot of its luster. I have really no hangups with this film. One small gripe is there is a kind of a more prominent actor who shows up later on that did pull me out of the film for a little bit. And then I turned to my buddy after the movie was done. I said, I could have done without that. I could have done without that character. It just kind of took away from the importance of the mission and it brought me into this other kind of this other place where I was like, oh, he's in this. That's fun. But I didn't want to say that. I wanted it to be a nobody so that I could stay with the character and his journey and help him complete it. There's a good amount of variety. There's some good heart. There's some good drama. It's got everything you look for in a war movie. If I were to compare it to one, I don't know if I really could. I don't think it's I think it's more like Dunkirk than Saving Private Ryan. There's no real gross stuff. I think it's PG-13. It's got to be. There's not really much swearing or anything. So, yeah, I highly recommend it, though. I think you're going to get your money's worth. And once again, see it in theaters if you're going to see it at all. It's worth your time. Thanks for watching the video. I hope you liked it. And if you did, feel free to subscribe if you haven't to Adam Does Movies. It's my main channel here on YouTube. If you really like what I'm doing, I have a second one called Adam Olinger. It talks about more than just movies. I rant about kind of random issues that have no real consequence, like leaving your shopping cart out in the middle of the parking lot or getting screwed on a coffee size or just something just ridiculous, you know, kind of first world problems. I do have a couple skit shows over there, like The Cringe, where I play a comical character. It's fun. It's dumb. It's loose. And we're having a good time. So yeah, subscribe to both if you want, and I'll see you next time.